Hi, my name is Steve Kitchen. I want to share with you a special thing I found about a year ago. The company name is called Celluvation. The products, what we do is we imbue our products with a special quantum waveforce technology, and this waveforce technology affects every single cell of your body right down to its genome. And how do we do this? We use a combination of chemistry, physics, and computer science in order to make our Celluvation gel products. George Daniel is the creator of the gel technology. Dr. James Oshman said something brilliant. He said cells in our body are very sensitive to energy fields, and they are amplifiers and they listen to whispers from their environment. Our bodies and cells respond much more to subtle stimuli rather than to violent stimuli. So this involves feather-like, very gentle applications or organized energy with information and frequency encoded information that is appropriate to stimulate cells to do repair and to deliver electrons to the site of inflammation. Our usual way is to do battle, like for example our war on cancer. Well, we lost that war. Why use a sledgehammer when a feather will do the job, says Dr. Oshman. Let me introduce you to our most advanced nutraceutical on the planet, and it's called our Dulces gel, with imbued testosterone, ketone, and oxaloacetate acid frequencies. We'll explore our three different frequencies, starting with our ketone frequency. The body burns three things for fuel, and those are fat, protein, and carbs. When you eat carbohydrates like pizza, baked goods, bread, and pastry, your body easily converts all that good-tasting food to sugar. And then insulin is created to help that sugar get into your cells for fuel. What is the problem with that? Well, we consume too much food, and thus the body puts all that quickly made sugar in storage in the form of fat. If you wanted to start a campfire, you would use a match or a small kindling to start the fire. The match burns hot and fast in order to start the kindling, which is in turn ignites the logs. Burning carbohydrates is the same as burning the match and kindling. When you burn fat, it's like burning the logs in a fire. They burn slow and last long, by giving off your energy in the same way fat does. It is a steady, prolonged energy, not like the energy derived from carbohydrates. The fat turns into ketones in the liver, and you burn the ketones as a fuel source. What are ketones? Ketones are molecules that your cells and brain happily use as fuel in the absence of glucose. There are three primary ketones, or ketone bodies, that can be detected in your bloodstream when your body is in ketosis, and these are acetoacetate, beta-hydroxybutyric acid, or BHP, and acetone. There's a lot of inflammation produced when mitochondria only burn glucose. Mitochondria are energy-producing units in the cell. Mitochondria vary in number and location according to the cell type. Some cells have only one mitochondria, but for example, your heart muscle cells contain about 5,000 mitochondria per cell. And that is more mitochondria per cell than anywhere else in the body. Our brains prefer to burn ketones instead of glucose. You can, in 4 days with a high-fat diet, turn your brain mitochondria to burn ketones, where at day one they were just burning glucose. Mitochondria use glucose and ketones in order to produce energy. And that is why we put ketone frequency in our gel number 4. Now let's take a look at the benefits of testosterone supplementation. Testosterone helps to upregulate your thyroid. It creates new neural pathways in the brain. It improves brain power and cognitive function. It helps remove synaptic junk. Helps to improve insulin sensitivity. It upregulates the production of ATP, cellular energy. Increases muscle mass, slows down the aging process. And testosterone is lipophilic. That means the fat is being dissolved. Hydrolysis of fat happens. The elimination of fat occurs. It is cardioprotective, as cardiovascular issues are normally due to a shortage or deficiency of testosterone. Testosterone suppresses inflammatory cytokines. Those are signaling molecules that get inflammation rolling in your body. If you have optimal levels of testosterone in your body, male as well as female, when sex drive is good, alertness, concentration is good, mood, motivation, confidence, sleep quality is improved, Heart health, improved blood pressure, cholesterol and inflammation of your heart is improved. Muscle mass, strength, joint health. One will have better sperm production and better erectile function. Bone density is increased. Blood cell production, bone marrow works better. A decreased risk of prediabetes, diabetes and heart disease. Reduction in belly fat and size of body fat. Basically, one basically looks younger and feels younger with testosterone supplementation. So if your energy is gone, motivation is gone, get your life back with testosterone gel number 4. And one of the reasons for this, or there's a number of reasons, but due to lifestyle, testosterone levels are drastically reduced. Like for example, in World War I and World War II, men actually had 2 to 4 times more testosterone coursing through their bodies than men now. And the reason is because there is a chemical, an environmental onslaught on your testosterone levels and your endocrine system. For cell phone towers, your cell phone radiation that comes out of your phone, the plastics that we ingest in our food chain, all these produce a lower of our testosterone and a disruption of our endocrine system. So we have to supplement, especially after the age of 30, because that's when testosterone levels start to dwindle. Now let's take a look at our third frequency, called oxaloacetate acid. This is the frequency we imbue in our gel number 4 also. Now it was found with supplementation that glucose levels swing was reduced by 55%. In Japan in 1968, there was a study done with diabetic patients and there was a decrease in glucose fasting levels by 24%. And the reason there wasn't any more research papers after this was that because oxaloacetate is a natural substance that occurs in every single cell of your body. Oxaloacetate protects against mercury toxicity, aluminum toxicity, cyanide poisoning. It helps with NAD increase, and that is what is necessary in your body in order to burn food. Even mitochondrial NAD is increased by using that supplementation. US Open Triathlon Elite medalist Renee Milton said, "Oxaloacetate has allowed me to compete as if I'm 25 years younger. It provides me with a huge competitive edge as my endurance is substantially increased. Oxaloacetate also decreases plaque density in the hippocampus. It also increases synaptic plasticity and spatial memory. In different studies, it protects mitochondrial DNA. Also, it reduced ischemia and closed head injury by 80%. It also reduced neurological damage from stroke and reduce neurological damage from epilepsy. Oxaloacetate is a potent antioxidant. So let's take a look at a closer look at what ketones can do for us. The brain can operate on glucose for fuel, but just as well and better on ketone bodies. Ketones add a brain stabilizing effect. If your blood glucose stays 75 or below, there's a good chance that you're in ketosis. Exogenous ketones, that means coming from outside the body, are really good for those times when one is under stress and one falls off the wagon and you want to eat sugar. So taking exogenous ketones, you will have then ketones floating around in your bloodstream, and that is a good idea even before you consider a diet of any kind, because the mitochondria will then burn the ketones instead of glucose and help you overcome that transition between burning glucose and burning ketones. To last longer than 2-3 hours that exogenous ketones can give, one consume medium chain triglycerides like MCT oil first thing in the morning with our Cellevation coffee that has the ketone frequency in it. So our freshly ground French press brewed coffee can be blended with grass-fed butter and MCT oil, for example. This is recommended to be sipped during the morning on an empty stomach. The coffee is so tasty that no cream or sweetener is needed. Cellevation is the only coffee in the world that has the ketone frequency in it. If you take MCT oil, it goes to the liver via the portal vein and it is turned into ketones pretty quickly. One can use ketones when you need brain performance. Here is one result of using our Cellevation gel number 4 doses. Ketones are a wonderful thing for kids with acne. High fluctuations of sugar will cause acne and inflammation of the skin. The underlayer of the new skin forming and being present in 90 days will alleviate that problem. Mental performance is also reduced when blood sugar in your system goes up and down. So children should not carb load before a test, because in an hour and a half, they will literally crash mentally. When one is in ketosis, energy levels are stable and high. Another very good way to raise ketones in the body is also by intermittent fasting. Ketones shift your neurological pathways in your brain. They are shifting brain energy metabolism. It's shifting the glutamate to GABA ratio. Glutamate is a powerful excitatory neurotransmitter that is released by nerve cells in the brain. It is responsible for sending signals between nerve cells, and under normal conditions, it plays an important role in learning and memory. GABA is considered an inhibitory neurotransmitter because it blocks or inhibits certain brain signals and decreases activity in your nervous system. Exogenous ketones can lower inflammation of the joints, have a calming effect on a person's disposition. Ketones in your nervous system have an anticonvulsant effect in the case of people who have seizures. It is also giving your brain a form of energy that is superior to glucose. There was a study of the heart where ketones were found to be a superior source of fuel compared to glucose. Ketones provide a higher amount of cellular energy when combined with oxygen in the process of metabolism compared to using glucose. The inability of the brain to metabolize glucose, for example, like an Alzheimer's disease, results in the brain then become insulin resistant. Alzheimer's disease also promotes the formation of plaque in the brain. As we age, glucose pathways in the brain become reduced, but ketone pathways stay open. Ketones readily cross membranes in the brain and can be used as fuel for the mitochondria to form ATP, which is a cellular form of energy. Ketones restore normal metabolic function. This using of ketones also accelerates the production of neurotransmitter systems. The brain of Alzheimer's disease patients can readily use ketones for fuel, where glucose they cannot. If you elevate your blood to have 1 to 2 to 3 millimolars of ketones, then you know you are supplementing fuel to the brain. Beta hydroxybutyrate, or BHB, is epigenetic, and it can turn pro-survival genes on. If you introduce lower glycemic foods like vegetables, that would also help. This will reduce glucose and insulin spikes, and that will reduce insulin resistance. If they're eating like 200 to 300 grams per day of carbohydrates, you want to bring down the carbohydrates down to lower than 100 grams per day. Surround yourself with people that are supportive of you. Decrease your stress and increase your creative downtime, and not being in the fight or flight mode all the time is most important for life, longevity, and health. Also, put yourself in a position of service where you're giving back and work in those areas that are fulfilling, and you being passionate about something and serving others is the most important for one's health, over and above even being in ketosis. I hope you enjoyed the presentation today. Please get back to the person who sent you this video, and please send this out to all the people that you love and care for. Thank you very much for your time. God bless.